shortcut formula. Now here shortcut formula will be helpful, but then you have to be good in calculation, of course, right? So there is a regular method of solving this question. We can assume the first case where he has gone, reached 6 minutes late. We can say the time taken is t plus 6. In the second case where he has reached 10 minutes early, we can say the time taken is t minus 10 and so on. But instead of doing all that, just look at the shortcut formula, the direct formula here. Shortcut formula. How does it work? Distance is equal to S1 into S2 into delta t divided by S1 difference S2. If you remember this formula, you can solve this very popular question from time and distance in a jiffy, provided you do your quick calculations. So, formula is S1 into S2 into delta t divided by S1 difference S2. Now, what are S1 and S2? The speeds, 2.5 and 3 kilometers per hour respectively. What is this delta t? Now, this delta t is the difference of the time. Time when he has reached late plus the time when he has reached early. Now, you might be wondering, when it is delta t, which is supposed to be the difference, why are we adding? See, we are adding because in one case he is late, in the other case he is early. So, it is like this. If you look at the x-axis, this is the origin, let's say. When he is late, let's say he is on this side. When he is early, he is on this side. So, overall the difference is what? The addition. So, let's say he is late by 10 minutes. So, minus 10. He is early by 6 minutes. So, plus 6. When I have to find out the difference, this length, how much is it? Is it 4 or 16? It is 16. 6 on this side, 10 on this side. So, 16. Total distance 16. So, delta t has to be calculated carefully. He is 6 minutes late and 10 minutes early. Suppose the right time to reach the school is 9 a.m. Let's say. When he is 6 minutes late, he will reach at 9:06 a.m. When he is 10 minutes early, he reaches at 8:50 a.m. Now, we are supposed to find the difference between these two times. How much is the difference? 8:50 a.m. to 9:06 a.m. 16 minutes. Or simply add 6 minutes plus 10 minutes, 16 minutes. So, that delta t here is equal to 16. Substitute the values. 2.5 into 3 into delta t is 16 minutes divided by S1 difference S2. Now, what is 2.5 difference 3? 0.5. Yes or no? 2.5 difference 3, 0.5. One important point to be noted here is the speeds S1, S2 and the difference are all in kilometers per hour. Kilometers per hour. Yes or no? Kilometers per hour. But the time that we have taken is in minutes. 16 minutes. So, the units are not balanced, right? One is in kilometers per hour. The other one is in minutes. So, you have to convert minutes to hours. How do you convert 16 minutes to hours? Divide by 60. That's it. Simplify this and you know what the answer is. You're able to follow. We have divided by 60 because we want to convert 16 minutes to hours. 16 minutes is equal to 16 by 60 hours. Now, calculate. 0.5 goes 5 times. 5 into 3 is 15. 15 here goes 4 times. 16 by 4 is 4. 4 kilometer is your answer. Option B. Right? There are other ways of doing it. I mean, if you do not know the shortcut formula, what you can do?
The difference between the two times
is equal to, see, time in one case minus time in the other case is equal to 16 minutes. What is time? Distance by speed. So, distance by 2.5 minus, distance is same in both the cases. Distance by 3 is equal to 16 by 60. Same calculation from this formula only, from this method only, we have derived the shortcut formula. Right? When you take d common and do all that calculation, you will get the same answer. S1 into S2 into delta t divided by S1 difference S2. So, this is what basically is the concept. The difference of two times is 16 minutes. We are using the same concept. Time is equal to distance by speed. So, d by 2.5, here it is d by 3. The difference of these two is equal to 16 minutes. Why 16 minutes? We have discussed already. One is getting late, the other is getting early. So, the magnitude will get added, right? Because the sign has changed. Alright? So, either use this or if you can remember the shortcut formula, just substitute the values and get the answer.